Okay, so
guys, I tried to grow a mustache for the last month in order to make this review, this Super Mario movie review, and this is all that came out. Yeah. So the Super Mario movie is the movie based on, you guessed it, the Super Mario games. And whenever I heard that we're making a Mario movie, my first thought is that is a billion-dollar movie if there ever was one. I heard someone say Mario is the Mickey Mouse of the video game industry, and that is 100% right. So the movie has a simple enough plot, just like the games, and it's funny to me that people complain about how simple the story in this movie is, but Mario was never the pinnacle of storytelling by any means. And they did play it safe in this one, but you gotta cut them some slack. This is the studio that brought you Minions. If the Minions made a shit ton of money, Mario, the most recognizable video game character of all time, is gonna break a billion easily. Probably by the time this video is out, it already has. So like I said earlier, the story, the plot is very easy to follow, just like the games, and this time, Mario and Luigi get split up. And the movie is so full of Easter eggs and references and nods to the history of Mario video games throughout the decades that it almost became overwhelming to see that many just coming at you. Like, this is probably the most Easter eggs I've ever caught watching something, and they were in your face sometimes. They were not subtle at all with any of those. There were visual Easter eggs and audio Easter eggs that if you paid attention, you could tell which game is the soundtrack they're using in the movie. They use different soundtracks, different music from different games. You can pick up on it really, really fast if you played the game. And that is so cool too, that they were able to translate and adapt the music of the games into a movie format. And it worked very, very well. So I don't know if you guys could tell, but my cat just pumped into my tripod and kind of moved the image a little bit. So if you notice that, hey, good on you. The cast in this movie was really good too. I will admit, I was one of the opposers to Chris Pratt's Mario. But he was actually really good in the role, and they walked around Mario's accent. They actually explained it in the movie. So Mario's accent is like a made-up thing they did for their commercials for their plumbing service, and that is genius. Charlie Day as Luigi was great too. Keegan-Michael Key was great as Toad, but the standout of the entire movie has got to be Jack Black as Bowser. I heard they cast Jack Black, and it was kind of a head scratcher, like, what, really? And then it made sense when they released that teaser they released like a year ago, where you see Bowser getting to the ice, to the Penguin Kingdom, and you hear his voice, oh, okay, that makes sense. And then you see the movie, and you see the musical aspect that Bowser has in the movie, and it makes even more sense that they cast Jack Black. And seriously, guys, if you have not heard Jack Black's band, it's called Tenacious D. Look it up. It's fucking fantastic. Anyways, Peaches, I will not lie to you. I was humming and singing Peaches for days after I came out of watching this movie. It's the catchiest song since I remember. That's how catchy it is. There is a surprise voice role that I was not aware of before going in to watch this movie, and that is Seth Rogen as Donkey Kong. As soon as Donkey Kong did that Seth Rogen laugh, I knew it instantly. And he did it like 3 times. It's like, I get it, it's Seth Rogen. You have a very iconic laugh. So the movie moves at a breakneck pace. It moves really fast from point A to point B, but it's understandable because it's a kids movie and kids don't sit still very long. Still though, I think it was very coherent and it wasn't jarring in any way for me, so yeah. The ending was very satisfying, and they had two post-credit scene, and I'm gonna go into spoiler territory here, so if you don't want to know anything, although you've probably seen this movie because everyone's seen this movie, but just in case you haven't, you know, I'm gonna go into spoilers here. So the second post-credit scene is a Yoshi egg, and it kind of moves a little and it cracks, but what's the It cracks and then it's done. But what's the point of that when we already saw Yoshi? It was in the movie. There were a ton of them. Was for a split second of them, but yeah, we already seen them. Unless they do a crazy change in design, you didn't really tease anything. Anyways, guys, those are my thoughts on the Super Mario Bros. Movie. Have you seen it? What do you think about it? Let me know down in the comments below. Follow me on Instagram at caffeine.prince98 and on TikTok at NJUltraFlickShow. I don't have Twitter because I hate it, and Facebook is for the memes. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.